Hey everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you for clicking on today's video. So here on my channel, I'm really known for like my bra series, my bra 101 videos. I teach you a little bit about everything you need to know about bras pretty much because like where are you gonna learn this? They don't have college classes for this, I don't think. But if you're new to my channel, you never met me before, I've done a bra series here on my channel where I've talked to you about how to save money at Victoria's Secret, everything you wanna know about bras, the different styles of bras that are out there on the market. So I have a full playlist which I will leave down below in the description bar. But today I want to talk to you about 5 reasons you probably hate your bra, and maybe hopefully 5 solutions to these problems. I just want to mention that I'm not necessarily an expert. I have just worked previously at Victoria's Secret for so many years and I have seen thousands, I think. I confidently say like thousands of boobs from 13-year-olds all the way to like 70, 80 year olds. I've seen everything from women who have lost their breasts to breast cancer, all the way to pregnant women who have gained like 3 cup sizes. So that is my experience that I have that I'm talking to you guys with. I don't currently work at Victoria's Secret anymore, but everything that I've learned and everything that I've seen, everything I've remembered, I do have it inside of my little brain here. So that is where all of this is coming from. If you're curious and you're like, who is she? I don't trust you. Where do you know your information from? Blah, blah, blah. That's where I get all of my information from. None of these things are necessarily facts. These are all just from my own experience, what has happened, what has worked well for people. So anyways, I just wanted to put that disclaimer out before we get started. I've got my handy dandy planner out. I have written down all of my points that I want to cover today because it's like class is in session. So maybe some of you have clicked on this video because you really want to know 5 reasons on why you don't like your bra. You may be putting it on in the morning and you're like, oh, I don't want to put a bra on. It sucks. Maybe at the end of a long day, the first thing you want to do is rip your bra off. That's me, or at least it used to be. I do want to bring up 2 very obvious points that maybe I don't need to say, but probably good to start off with. The first thing is that you're probably wearing the wrong size. That sounds so obvious. It's like when people say you have bad skin and they tell you to drink water. It's like, really? You don't have a better answer for me? So it's recommended that you get sized every 6 months because as women, as females, we gain and lose weight really easily. One of the first places you lose and gain weight is actually your breasts. When it comes to the time of the month, maybe your boobs swell a little bit, maybe they look a little bit smaller sometimes in the month. So our boobs actually fluctuate a ton. And that's the first thing I would say. So if you haven't gotten sized in the last 6 months, or maybe you don't even want to get size, but you are definitely feeling like your bras are too tight or too loose, then I would recheck, kind of look down at yourself and kind of look at how your bra is fitting you. You know, a lot of people don't even realize that their bras aren't even fitting them incorrectly because they're just used to how it feels because that's what they wear every single day. That's the first thing I would say. Check to see if you're in the right size. I do have a video down below teaching you how to size yourself for some bras. I will leave that down below. If you don't have a measuring tape or you would prefer having this done to you, a free service, and I would walk into your local Victoria's Secret or your Nordstrom, wherever you go to get your bras, I would go in there, try to grab a measuring tape or have somebody measure you and see if you're in the right size that you thought you were. The second point that I wanted to make, which really goes hand in hand with the fact that you're wearing the wrong size, is probably that your bra is really old or it's really stretched out. So bras, the lifespan of a bra is typically like a year. This is if you're not throwing it in the dryer, you're not like ruining it, the wires aren't popping, all that stuff. Like if there's one thing you can take away from this video, it would be don't throw your bras in the dryer, don't do it. Your wires are gonna pop out, you're gonna start getting t-shirt lines. When you walk into my room, there's just bras all over the place. But what happens when you dry your bra is that this material here on the face of the bra, on the cup, is really gonna start to shrink. And then as it shrinks here, do you see how this lip kind of lifts up like that? That's where you're gonna show all of those t-shirt lines. So that's why I think it's important that you guys don't throw your bras in the dryer. If you have a rack, hang them or lay them flat, which is what's recommended, laying them flat to dry. But back to the point, your bra is probably really stretched out, super worn out. The lace on it is all ripping and tearing. And if that's you, and even if the wires are slightly popping out and you find yourself like duct taping them to make sure that they don't cut into your skin, if that's you, I would recommend tossing that bra. Just throw it away and don't look back. Trust me, it'll be the best thing that you've ever done for yourself. It's not worth it. This is something that you wear every single day. It's something that you probably work in, you carry your kids in. Let's move on to the reasons. The first thing I want to say is, are your wires cutting you? Are your wires on your bras just feeling like they're poking into you? So let's say you put your bra on in the morning and after a couple hours, all you're doing is this and you're shifting your bra. You do like a lot of this action. If that's you, if you feel like the wire is just irritating your skin, it's not comfortable for you at all, I would highly recommend a wireless bra. And I know that sounds really dumb. I know that sounds like super obvious and it's like, what? But honestly speaking, for those of you who like bras that are wired, still try a wireless bra. Wireless bras have really changed the game recently. The way that a wireless bra is still gonna give you support is that even underneath the padding or the cup, there will be more padding in the bottom for your breast tissue to sit. It's not gonna be like this flat piece of, you know, fabric, just no wires, no support. It won't be like that. Actually, surprisingly, for me personally, I like the t-shirt wireless style at Victoria's Secret. I don't like the Sexy Illusions just because the Sexy Illusions collection has this like golden metal V and it just makes my skin green. So I'd recommend going for the t-shirt wireless collection from Victoria's Secret. I'm only referencing Victoria's Secret bras because I used to work there. If you feel like your bra is really tight and it's cutting into you, you take a deep breath, you're like, and then like your bras are just stabbing you like knives. So I would try a wireless bra. I definitely think a wireless style is gonna help fix the problem. Okay, second thing is, let's say you feel like you have no support in your bras. Every time you like lean forward, it's just kind of nipples to the wind. If that's you, I would definitely recommend pulling those straps a little bit tighter. So let's say you did get sized recently, but you still feel like this bra's kind of loose. Like the cups are definitely flapping and flying out. I feel like you can probably see my boobs. If that is you, I would recommend tightening the straps in the back. What this does is obviously it's gonna bring those cups a little bit closer to you, but you don't want it so tight that the band is like riding up your back and it's like at an angle. Give your straps a little bit, a nice pull down, maybe an inch to an inch and a half, and you should probably see a big difference in the way that your bra feels. For those of you who feel like your straps are falling off all the time, try a racerback style. With most of the Victoria's Secret bras, you can unclasp the bra strap and kind of exit in the back and make it a racerback style, which I think is really functional. I know it's kind of an extra step, but for those of you who kind of have more of a slanted shoulder, the bra strap will tend to kind of just slide right off, even though you've tightened it so much and you even have like an indent on your shoulder. I would recommend trying a front closing bra or just crossing the back for your bra, or I would recommend getting a bra with wider straps. The t-shirt collection has recently launched the logo band, so I noticed that those straps are much bigger than what it used to be. The next reason you might hate your bra is because maybe you have two different cup sizes. Maybe one's a D and one's a double D, or one's an A and one's a B. That is so normal. I've heard myths like the left is always a little bit bigger than the right. I don't know if that's really true, but I did have a lot of customers who came in and they were like, I do have one cup is much bigger than the other. You wanna make sure you get a bra size that fits the larger cup versus the smaller one, because with the smaller one, you can always tighten up that strap and it should automatically tighten up and flatten out at the top. But you wanna make sure that the other larger cup size is supported. So definitely fit to the larger cup than the smaller one, first point. Second point is trying out a perfect shape or something that has a molded cup. Imagine wearing a coconut bra. That's really similar to what a perfect shape bra would be like. It has a molded cup and it's not really going anywhere. You'll look a little bit more even, and even if you feel like slightly more gapping, because of how hard the cup is shaped, like it's hard, it, not hard, but there's just more of a shape to it, it won't look as deflated, if that makes sense. So with an unlined style or a more lightly lined style, in that situation, you might feel like it's even more loose because it's not a molded cup and it's looking a little like a deflated balloon. So the next reason why you might hate your bra is because maybe you get back rolls. I know that this is something that a lot of people feel like it just happens. What I would recommend in that situation is something called a Sexy Illusions bra. that looks like this. It's got a seamless raw cut so that when it is laying against your skin, no matter how tight it is, it just, it looks like an extra layer of skin. It's seamless like that. Or if you feel like you want your whole back to be flat, I would recommend the True Body Bra by True & Co. This is almost like a sports bra that is completely made in this material. I've worn it underneath t-shirts and I have found that it gives my back just like the most seamless look. You can't even see, it looks like, it doesn't even look like I'm wearing a bra. It's really comfortable. I can literally run a mile probably in that bra, which I love. I do have a video on my channel where I show you what bras I wear when I don't want to wear a bra at all. So I will leave a link also to that video down below, but you want to look for something that's seamless. They also make underwear in this type of material. I know Victoria's Secret makes it. I know True & Co. makes it. And I personally love the True & Co. ones over the Victoria's Secret ones. Shameless plug, you can get 10% off with the code INMYSEAMS. If you feel like, you know, you do wear dresses or you wear tighter shirts and you feel like your back fat is showing, because that's just normal. Like no matter what body type you have, a lot of people have that same struggle with wearing a band or wearing a bra that has a band that's really cutting into them and kind of accentuating their back. So that is something that I would definitely recommend to you guys, trying out a seamless band. So those are all of the reasons and tips and things that I wanted to mention in this video. I feel like it was a little bit confusing, but for those of you who have these issues with your bras and you feel like, yeah, that's me, then definitely give this video a thumbs up. Let me know if there's a very specific concern or problem that you have with your current bra or your breasts down below. I'll try my best to answer your questions. I hope you guys found this video helpful, even by a little bit. I'll leave all products, suggestions, recommendations all down below. So check out the description and just try them out. I mean, the reason that Victoria's Secret calls it a bra journey is because you want to try out the styles that are going to work for you, the styles that you're going to like. The styles that I like may not be the same styles that you guys like. So definitely go into whatever store, Victoria's Secret, H&M, Nordstrom, wherever you go to buy your bras, go in and see the styles that they have. Try to figure out what problems or struggles that you have with your bras, and then try to find a bra that is out there on the market that's gonna kind of help your specific need. So those are all the things that I wanted to share with you all today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, I would really appreciate if you subscribed down below. I hope you guys have a great rest of your weekend. I will talk to you guys all in my next video. Bye!